Good morning, friends. Now, in the last class, we have seen example problem 6. You do the cross product, you will get the answer. Clear? Next, come to the 7th example problem. A rigid wire consists of a semicircular portion of a radius r and two straight sections shown in figure. The wire is partially immersed in a perpendicular magnetic field B shown in figure. Find the magnetic force on the wire if it carries a current I. And question B. A wire carrying a current I is kept in XY plane along the curve Y is equal to A sin 2 pi X by lambda. Magnetic field B exists in the Z direction. Find the magnitude of the magnetic force on the portion of the wire between X is equal to 0 and X is equal to Y. Now come to the question A. Example problem 7. Question A. Now field, they given cross field, cross field in the sense, symbol is given cross. What does that mean? Field moving into the board here. Like this, field is acting. In this field, a conductor plays like this. It carries current I. Current direction is given like this. Okay? Now they are asking your force acting on this. What is the force formula? F is equal to B I L sin theta. When a current carrying conductor plays in a magnetic field, force experienced by the conductor formula is F is equal to B I L sin theta. Clear? Now theta is the angle between L and B. Here this is the conductor length. Big field is acting like this, so theta is equal to 90. For this also field is acting perpendicular to this conductor. This conductor also same. So this I made into three segments. First segment, second segment and third segment. Clear? First and third, answer is remain same. F is equal to B I L. For first and top. But direction of forces is different. Reason, current direction changed. Clear? So in this case we need to cut the element like this. So we will try to decide direction of force for this element. What did I say? Hey. Okay, this is moving means what? This is representing the Z direction. Means it is field is acting along negative X axis. So B direction is what? Minus K. Current is acting along upwards. So current element direction is J. Cross product we need to take IL cross B. So then IL cross B means J cross minus K. So this, how can we write? Minus J cross K. Clear? J cross K means I J K. J cross K. What is this? J cross K. What we will get? I. So we will get, already minus is there, so we will get minus I. Clear? Minus I means it experiences force in this direction. Now, for this element, magnetic field direction remains same, but current element acting downwards. So then, for second case, what happened? Instead of J, this is for which section? First section. and now third segment or third conductor, third portion. Current element acting downwards. Upwards we taken J for this conductor. Now for this conductor it is minus J cross minus K. So minus minus plus, this is J cross K. J cross K means I. This force will act in this direction. I mean the force on this conductor act in this direction. What is the net force? Magnitudes remain same. Magnitudes remain same. Acting opposite in direction, the net force on this is zero. So remaining is second one. This is curve. In this case, we will take effective length. Means we will draw a line from initial where the curve started and where the curve ended. So this one. Clear? Understand? Did they mention the radius? Yes, they mentioned radius is r. Then the total length is what? 2r. Clear? The effective length. For this case, force is equal to, for which segment? Second segment. Force is equal to B and L sin theta. Again theta 90, B as it is, I as it is, length L. Length is what? Effective length. This is what? 2r. So 2r b I is the force acting on the conductor. Clear? Now B also same. Question B, the given figure, effective length is lambda. So again formula is remains. Instead of L, take lambda. B I lambda. Clear? Direction, how do we decide? Based on that, decide. Clear? Now, this direction, the force experienced by this effective length rod, we need to decide. Again, we will follow the same for second. What is effective length acting along which direction? I. So, I mean, along positive x axis, so this represents I cap. So, magnetic field is acting along minus K. So, this is minus I cross K. I cross K, what do we get? We are going anti-clockwise, we will get this value is minus J. So minus of minus plus J. Plus J means it experiences force upwards. So this conductor experiences force upwards. Clear? So the same method follow for second question also. Clear? Now we will see motion of a charged particle in a combined electric and magnetic fields. Already we have seen in Lorentz force. Clear? The force experienced by the charged particle due to electric field is F is equal to QE, and magnetic field force experienced by charged particle due to magnetic field or by magnetic field is Q into V cross B. Clear? If we combine these two forces, we have written in the vector form, then that we call it as, that equation we call it as Lorentz force. And when it is maximum, when it is minimum, it's depend on the angles. They given detailed information in this description. Once you check this concept, next one is magnetic moment. Already we have done magnetic moment. This we denoted with in this lesson capital M, or sometimes with small m. Okay, don't confuse. In this lesson, capital M and small m refers magnetic moment or magnetic dipole moment. Clear? Or simply always we call it as a magnetic moment. This magnetic moment formula is what? Current into area. Okay? If the coil has n number of turns, we multiply with capital N. If they provide small n, we multiply with small n. Okay? If they represent number of turns small n, we multiply with small n. If it is capital N, capital N. Clear? Capital N. Units already ampere, meter, square. Clear? How do we decide the direction? Already I have shown, if you take the area like this, current moves like this, keep the thumb in the direction of current, curl the fingers into the area, then magnetic field act, magnetic moment act perpendicular to this one. Clear? Okay? For anti-clock, this is anti-clockwise, in this direction clockwise. Then moving in perpendicular back side. This is perpendicular front side. Clear? It's depend on the current direction. Okay. Next, torque on a current loop. Torque on a current loop. We have seen tau is equal to B I L A sine theta. This is for single loop. We have n number of turns. N V A N P B I N A. Clear? So not L. This is P I A sine theta. And we have a n number of terms. N B I N A sine. The extra term is L. Clear? Theta is here very very important point. Theta is the angle between area vector of the coil to magnetic field, not plane of the coil to magnetic field. See, if you have a magnetic field like this, if take this as a book as a rectangular loop, okay, of course, see, this, if I keep like this, the plane of the coil making 90 degree with the magnetic field. This is magnetic field B. The plane of the coil making, what is the angle? 90 degree. But what is the area vector? It is parallel. Of course, magnetic moment also acting in this direction. Understand? Theta is angle between magnetic moment and field. When plane is perpendicular, this will become parallel. Which one? The magnetic moment vector or area vector is parallel. Understand? Means zero. Remember, the question, the angle given with respect to plane or with respect to normal, this is nothing but normal. Understand? So we always take this theta angle between normal and magnetic field. Sometimes they will provide with the plane. If they provide the plane, if they provide the angle with the plane, then angle with the normal vector is angle with normal vector. Normal vector is 90 minus theta. Remember, when if they provide angle with loop with the plane of the loop, okay, then with the normal angle is 90 minus theta. All the cases they will provide, they will give the angle with the normal only. To make you convinced to find the correct angle, sometimes they will provide with the plane. Understand? Okay. Torque equation given here. You see, tau is equal to mb sine theta, where mb is the magnetic moment, b is magnetic field. Vector form is m cross b, where m is equal to magnetic moment nia. Okay. Now, example 8. Very interesting. Example 8. Find the magnetic moment of a thin round loop which with current if the radius of the loop is equal to R is equal to 100 mm and the magnetic induction at the center is equal to 6 into 10 power or 6 micro. A problem. Okay. Loop given. Single loop. Carries current I. Field at center given B is equal to 6 micro Tesla, radius R. Okay, now R is equal to, what did they give R value? 100 mm. This is 100 into 10 power minus 3. This is equal to 10 power 2 zeros goes. What do we get? Minus 1 meter. Next, B is equal to 6 micro Tesla. This is equal to 6 into 10 power minus 6 Tesla. Now, they are asking M, magnetic moment of this loop. Now, magnetic moment formula is what? I into area. Current into area. Okay, this is equal to I into pi r square. R already given. We need to find I. I we need to find using magnetic field. So magnetic field at the center of the loop. Current loop is single loop is mu naught I by 2 r. Make it I subtractive from this. I is equal to 2 r b by mu naught. Okay. Now this I value substitute in magnetic moment formula. So magnetic moment is equal to 2 r b by mu naught into pi r square. So this we can write 2 b r cube by into pi by mu naught. Okay, now substitute the values. 2 as it is. B value 6 into 10 power minus 6. R value is 10 power minus 1 whole cube into pi by mu naught value 4 pi into 10 power minus 7. Pi cancel. 2 1s, 2 2s, 2 1s, 3. So 3 into 10 power minus 6. 10 power minus 3 whole cube is minus 3. 10 power minus 7 comes up. It is plus. So this is 3 into 10 power minus 9 plus 7 minus 2 ampere meter square. Clear? Okay. They given 3 into 10 power minus 2 ampere meter square. Now example 9. An electron moves with a constant speed v along the circle of radius r. Find the equivalent current through a point on its path. Find the magnetic moment of the circulating electron. Find the ratio of magnetic moment to the angular momentum of the electron. Already we have derived this. Same equations we will find in our classroom discussion. PU discussion. I is equal to Q by T we followed. Then we got EV by 2 pi R. This is the current expression. When an electron, not only electron, if the proton also revolve, positive charge. Clear? Around the fixed orbit. Generally, proton is not revolve, only electron is revolve. That's what. So, current is equal to EV by 2 pi R. Next, M is equal to I into A. We have done that is EVR by 2, and we have taken the ratio magnetic moment to angular momentum. This we call it as gyromagnetic ratio. Clear? So, test your knowledge too. There are simple questions, you can find that. Now come to level 1. First question, magnetic field B at the center of the square loop is. Question number 1. Magnetic field B at the center of the square loop is. They given square like this. Clear? Center they ask. Distance they given, side length is given 2D, current entering at this corner and leaving from this corner. Then what happened? Current will split like this, I1 and I2. This is total current I. Again, same amount of current will leave the corner. Clear? Okay, given like this. So, which combination is? Parallel combination and conductor length also same. So, the same amount of current will be split here. Understand? So, I1 is equal to I2. Okay, this will become I by 2 and I by 2 because conductor lengths are same. Always, I already mentioned in the last video when the combination is parallel. See, what happened? Potential drop is remains same at this. Based on that concept, we will get the zero field. See, suppose if you follow the general also, this field will act inside. See, this is the current direction. Inside. For this conductor, at a given point, it is coming out. This field will be cancelled. And this one, this field produced by this conductor acting in, this one coming out at a given point. We need to check the curling finger direction. Clear? Here also this side moving in, this point we are not calculating, they given here. So we need to curl the finger in this region. See, understand? So what I answer is zero, because each field cancelled by this field produced by this conductor cancels by field produced by this conductor. Similar, or if you follow the derivation, what do we get? We will get potential drop saying that two I1T, what is that, I1R1 is equal to I2R2. We will put the subtraction, they will be cancelled. We check in the last video. Now come to second question. In the given figure, the magnitude of magnetic field at a point O, they given conductor like this. First straight conductor and they bend like this. And current moving like this. They given direction. They are asking field at O. This is O. Okay, this I made into three segments. First one, and this is semicircular. Two, this radius is R dimension. Next, this three. Okay, first one, first segment is straight line, second segment is semicircle, third also straight. For first segment B1, point is on the axis of the conductor. On the axis of the conductor, field is 0. Next, B2, field due to semicircle. Clear? So, in terms of angle, what is the formula? Mu naught I theta by, what is that? 4 pi r, 2 pi r? It is 4 pi r. Okay, let me check. In terms of theta, these in terms of theta it is raised 4 pi r. Now mu naught I, what is the angle subtended by this semicircle? It is pi. Pi by 4 pi r. Clear? So pi pi cancel. So this we have mu naught I by 4 r. Next, B3 is field produced by this conductor. This is what? Infinitely conductor but at one end. What is the formula? Mu naught I by 2 pi d. Just the in this three, just we calculated magnitudes but not directions. Now find the directions. According to current direction, this is a, for finding the direction of the field produced by the semicircle. Keep the thumb in the current direction, curling. So this is moving in, means cross. This is moving into the pole. Now come to this. This is the current direction. Again, this is also moving in, cross. Add these two, we will get the answer. This answer I am writing, total field so B is equal to, these two are acting in same direction, so I am adding B1 plus, not B1 is 0, so B2 plus B3. Okay, this is equal to, what is B2? Mu naught I by 4R plus mu naught I by D value is what? Distance is what? R. So this instead of D, we need to substitute R. 2 pi R. What is common? Mu naught I by R is common. So mu naught I by R is common. What is there here? Mu naught I by R common 4 plus. Here mu naught I by R common. So, or we can take 2 are common. That is very. If 2 are goes, this will be 1 by 2 plus mu naught I by 2 are taken common. This is 1 by pi. These two are in the acting same direction, you keep it cross. Check the answer. Mu naught I by 2R of plus under again then again. Oh, answer is okay. Here for infinitely long at one end, what is the formula? It is not 2 pi d, it is what? 4 pi d. I take a formula for general formula. So, but at one end it is 4 pi d. Clear? So, here it will become, it is 4, then 4 are common, then this it will get 1. 4 are common, then here instead of 2 we will get 1. So, 1 plus 1 by 5. So, keeping the formulas in our mind is very very important. So we should perfect formulas. Clear? Question number 3. The magnetic field at the center of the circular coil is, they give a conductor like this, one circular coil. In this current carries, current moves in an anti-clockwise direction. The radius are given. Current is I and one more conductor passing like this. So this is also carries current I. Already we have done this kind of problems. So one is this considered as one segment and this is another segment. So field produced by the loop at the center, take it B1, this is O. Okay, field produced by the straight conductor is B2. Now B1. Field produced at the center due to circular coil, mu naught I by 2R. Next, this is B1. B1 is field produced by the loop. Next, B2 is field produced by the straight conductor. This is mu naught I by a straight conductor. So, it is 2 pi d. Okay, at one end it is 4 pi d. But it is not at one end. Clear? Infinitely long. The point is not at one end. So then answer is, formula is mu naught I by 2 pi d. Now currents, magnitude same. Now decide the directions. Keep the thumb in the direction of current. Curl the finger where the point is given. At the point, the fingers are coming out. Then this is dot. And now, this is a straight conductor. Keep the thumb and curl it. Again, curling fingers are coming out. Both are in same direction. Then net field B is equal to B1 plus B2. Both are acting in the same direction. So mu naught I by 2R plus mu naught I by 2 pi. What is the here? Distance is nothing but R. So this is R. B is equal to R. So mu naught I by 2R, 2R common, 1 plus 1 by pi. What is the direction? Dot. Clear?
Is there option mu naught I by 2R, 1 plus dot? Is there? Clear? So option A is correct. Now come to fourth question. What is the fourth question? Two long parallel straight conductor carries current I1 and I2, I1 greater than I2. When the currents are in the same direction, the magnetic field at the midway between the wires is alpha. If the direction of I2 is reversed, the field becomes 4 alpha, the value of I1 by I2. Two situations given.
To understand, I am taking just one plane. Here two conductors are there like this. One is carries current I1, another one carries current I2. But they mention I1 is greater than I2. Then I1 greater than I2, what does it mean? First conductor produces more magnetic field. Okay, B is directly proportional to I, according to formula, this formula. Okay.
Now, two long parallel straight conductor carries I1 and I2. When the currents are in the same direction, the magnetic field at a point midway between the wires. Let us suppose this is the midpoint.
this distance you take it, let us say total distance, if you take it 2d, okay, then half the distance means d, and this is d. When the currents are in same direction, net field B is equal to, what is the magnetic field at a midway between the wires is alpha. Okay, we are taking first case, so B1. So this field produced by the you take it, this as a B dash. Field produced by the first wire, you take it B1. Field produced by the second wire is B2. Okay, first we need to find the field between these two. So according to this, first wire field direction moving in, second wire is coming out, both are in opposite direction. This wire field is at in this direction B1, this wire field at in this direction. Check it once, keep the thumb, again moving in, I am writing in this direction, clear? For this coming out. So which is greater, B1 or B2? B1 is greater because I1 greater than I2. So B dash, how do we write? B1 minus B2. Then B1 formula is what? Magnetic field due to straight conductor. What we take in formula? Mu naught I by 2 pi. So this is mu naught I1 by 2 pi D minus mu naught I2 by 2 pi D. B dash given as what? Alpha. So this alpha, what is common? Mu naught I by mu naught by 2 pi D is common. I1 minus I2. This is according to first case. Now come to second case. Clear? Current I1. I2 reversed. Initially they are parallel. I1, I2, they are in the same direction. Second case, if the direction of I2 reversed, then I2 reversed. Then this operation we made it same. So this is D and this is D. Now what is the field in the second case? B double dash is given as 4 alpha. What did they give? 4 alpha. Now see the directions. This acts again in this direction. This is B1. Second key, second way, again this is also acting in same direction, B2. So both are acting in same direction, so B double dash, how do we write? B1 plus B2. Then this is mu naught I1 by 4 pi D plus mu naught I2 by 4 pi D. So B double dash given 4 alpha, this is 2 pi. 2 pi is straight connect. So 2 pi d, what is here mu naught by 2 pi d is common, then what we will get? I1 plus I2. This is equation 2. If these two solve, we will, what did they ask? I1 by I2 they are asking. Asked question is I1 by I2 question mark. Clear? Substitute alpha in equation 2. Then what do you get? 4 mu naught by 4 pi 2 pi d I1 minus I2 is equal to mu naught by 2 pi d I1 plus I2. Mu naught by 4, 2 pi d, 2 pi d cancel. 4 I1 minus 4 I2 is equal to I1 plus I2. I1 comes to this side. 4 I1 minus I1. I2 goes this side. I2 plus 4 I2. So 3 I1, 5 I2. I1 by I2 they asked. Then what happened? 5/3. Okay. See,
to understand, I give a clear explanation, but this you need to write directly. Based on the field directions, you need to write these two, then subsequently you will get the answer. This total is not required answer. Clear? To understand, I explain clearly. Now fourth question completed, fifth question. Consider a circular loop of radius r, the value of BP by B naught. The given figure.
Circular loop is given like this. Carries current I and axis. Center they mention as O. On the axis one point is given. This is P. And radius they mention as
R. What they are asking?
The ratio of field at
on the axis to field at center.
So BP by BO question mark. And they given this distance, center to P, distance is given, x is equal to root 15 r. This is also important model question. At the center of the loop, formula is what? This is BO is equal to mu naught I by 2 r. But on the axis, BP is what? Mu naught I r square by 2 into x square plus r square whole power 3 by 2. If 2 pi, if you multiply with pi and divide with pi, pi r square by 2 pi, pi r square is what? Area. That's what in the derivation I mentioned here, a, mu naught by a. Clear? Don't confuse. Now, substitute. BO is already known, BP where we need to calculate because x given. So this is mu naught I r square by 2 into x square means root 15 r. So this I can write 15 r square plus r square whole power 3 by 2. So it's completely depend on the calculation. That's all. So mu naught I r square by 2, 15 r square plus r square, 16 r square. 16 r square root 4 r cube is there. So this is 4 r cube. Clear? This is 15 r square plus r square, 16 r square. 16 r square, 16 r square whole power 3 by 2. This we can write 16 r square root whole power 3. Understand? Now this will be mu naught I r square by 2 into 4 r cube. 4 cube is what? 16 into 4. 4 into 4 into 4. So this is 64 r cube. 1 will be cancelled. 1 r is there here. This is what BB value. What they are asking? BB by B naught. Now this will be mu naught I by 2 into 64 r by mu naught I by 2 r. Okay, mu naught I cancel. 2 r goes up. So 2 r by 2 into 64 r. 2 r cancel. So 1 by 64. Is there? Yes. Option is given 3. Let me check the answer. Clear? Question number 5. Question number 5. Answer is given 3. Yes. Third option is correct. 1 by 64. So, but you follow no matter this value. So, we do expect this kind of questions. Clear? Next, sixth question.
Sixth question given. Figure given like this. Clear. Current is moving like this. I this is O. Dotted line is not conductor. Clear. So this length is given B and the radius is given A. Clear. The radius of this this how many portions are there? Three portions are there. Clear. Three quarter. Okay. Now what they are asking? The magnetic field at O of the loop which with current I. Okay, now we will make this into three segments. One, and this is one, this is one. Of course, this is also conductor, but dimension is small. Clear, for these two conductors, this conductor and this small conductor, the point lies on the axis. So on the axis field is zero. For this conductor, this point lies on this axis of the conductor. So this conductor and this conductor magnetic field at the point is zero, given point, because the point lies on the axis. So we need to find this magnetic field produced by this at this point and magnetic field produced by this conductor at this point, we need to find. So this first conductor, this is second conductor, this is third segments. First segment, if you follow magnetic field, what is that due to arc shape? So mu naught I, what is the angle subtended this at this? Clear. So 360 minus 90, 270. 270 in radius of the wave, 3 pi by 2 by 4 pi r. 4 by 4 pi cancel. This is mu 3 mu naught I by 2 comes down 8 r. Next B2. Clear. B2 means this is finite conductor at one end. Clear. So what is the formula? B is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi d cos theta 1 plus cos theta 2. Theta 1, what is the angle here? Angle subtended this end with the line theta 1 is 0. No, this is exactly not 0, it is 90. Next, this is theta 2. Clear. We need to find cos theta 2. Cos theta 2 means this length they mentioned as it is a square, this length also it is B. And this length also they mentioned as B. Then hypotenuse will be root 2 B. Then cos theta 2 will become what? This is theta 2 adjacent side by hypotenuse. Then cos theta 2 is equal to adjacent side is B by root 2 B. Clear. This B B cancel. We have 1 by root 2. Clear. Now this segment B
2 mu naught I by 4 pi d. Clear? What is theta 1? The 90 cos 90 0. So this we don't have. Cos theta 2 we calculate as 1 by root 2. Clear? Then b2 is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi. What is the perpendicular distance? This is b into 1 by root. Here also, here for this circle, radius we take an r, but they given a. So this is 3 mu naught I by 8 a. Next, field due to this conductor. Here. Understand? Again same. This length is b, this is angle theta 2, and this angle theta 1. Again, cos theta 2, adjacent side by hypotenuse. Clear? So then b3, we will get again same mu naught I by 2 pi b 1 by root 2. Clear? So now, based on the directions, now we will find the answer. Okay, for this, how the field is acting at this point, the direction of the field, the direction of the field moving. I kept the thumb in the direction of current, it is moving in. So this is cross, means this is cross. B2 thumb into the field, this is also cross, and this one moving in at this point, so this is also cross. Clear? And now all fields are in same direction, then net total field B is equal to B1 plus B2 plus B3. Okay, B1, 3 mu naught I by 8 a plus B2 mu naught I by 2 pi b into 1 by root 2 plus mu naught I by 2 pi b 1 by root 2. Clear? It is 4 pi actually, 4 pi is coming, yes? Why it is become, why I did write 2, 2, it's not 2, 4 pi is there. So, this is 4 pi, this is 4 pi, and this is 4 pi. Clear? So, 4 pi, 4 pi. Now, this is 2 times. So, 3 mu naught I by 8 a, how many times? 2 times. So plus 2 mu naught I by 4 pi b 1 by root 2. Clear? Mu naught I, if we take it common, okay, we do like that. Yes, we will do like that. Mu naught I, take it common, then what do we get? We will make it simple this, okay? Mu naught I is, take it common, what do we get? 3 by 8 a plus mu naught I taken common, 2 by mu naught I taken on 2 by 4 root 2 pi b. Clear? Is there this options with 4 root 2 is there? Then here root once, root 2 times. Clear? Or they taken 8 common, we'll do one thing, multiply and divide with 2 for this term. This we have what? 2. And this is root 2. Multiply and divide with 2, then this is multiplying with 2, dividing with 2. Then what do we get? Mu naught I 3 by 8a plus 4 by 8 root pi b. Now 8 taken common, mu naught I by 8 take it common, this is 3 by a plus 4 by root 2 pi b. Okay, so okay, we got in this 4 by root 2 pi b, but in options pi not given. So again we need to check this question. Here I will check this answer and I will give. Now come to 7th problem. Clear? A long straight metal rod has a very long pole of radius A drilled parallel to the rod's axis at a distance C from the axis of the rod shown. If the rod carries a current I, the magnetic field on the axis of pole. Clear? Seven, given figure. Okay, this is the wire cross section, long wire, cylindrical wire. Of course, wire is in cylindrical shape only. We are seeing the bigger view. The radius of this is B, and they made a hole here with a radius A, and the center to here is C. What they are asking? A long straight rod has a very long hole of radius A. Drill parallel to the rod axis. Distance C from the axis of the rod shown. If the rod carries a current I, the magnetic field on the axis of the pole. This rod is carrying I. Clear? Now this portion of rod is removed. Clear? So but total the current flowing through this is I. So if you remove, we need to find this portion current. Clear? So how do we find this current density formula? Clear? Current density is what? J is equal to I by A. Clear? Understand? So this area is removed. So this we can write I by area removed. Pi, what is the total area? Pi B square minus area removed. Pi A square. So this J is equal to I by pi is common, B square minus A square. Okay? They are asking field at this axis. If you apply the what Ampere's circuital law, integral B dot dl is equal to mu naught I. Clear? Understand? Now, this is I is enclosed by this loop. Clear? At this point they ask like this. Okay? Understand? So now this B is equal to integral dl is equal to mu naught I. Okay, now this I, this is I after removing this hole. This is before removing I. This I automatically write I is equal to J into A C. Clear? This is I C. Clear? Now this I C is equal to what? J into A C. J is what? I by pi B square minus pi, already pi common, taken common. So, B बी स्क्वायर माइनस ए स्क्वायर इनटू ए पाई सी स्क्वायर. ए सी स्क्वायर मींस एरिया ऑफ दिस सी विद द रेडियस सी. क्लियर? नाउ दिस आईसी वैल्यू सब्स्टिट्यूट हियर. बी इज इक्वल टू बी इंटीग्रल डीएल. डीएल मींस वी विल गेट दिस लूप एरिया. सो देन दिस इज 2 पाई सी इज इक्वल टू mu naught into what is IC? I pi c square by pi into b square minus a square. Clear? 1 c, c cancel. What do we get? 1 pi, pi cancel. Then b is equal to mu naught I y. Here c is there. Mu naught I c by this 2 pi goes this side. 2 pi b square minus a square. So this is the formula. This is the answer. Do we have that mu naught ic by mu naught ic by 2 pi into b square minus a square? Option 4 is there. Let me check this answer. Question number 7. Answer 4 is correct. See, this is this ring, this area is removed, then I calculated current density. Clear? Now that J is equal to I by pi into b square minus a square. They ask magnetic field at this point. So I taken this loop. Clear? Now field at this point. Apply the which one? Ampere circuit law. So we need to calculate current enclosed by this loop. This is in this area the current is IC. So B naught DL, U naught IC. IC how do we get? Using this formula. I is equal to what? Current density into area. Current density already J calculated. AC is the area of this one. Understand? So AC is area of pi c square. This radius is what? C. So I is equal to density formula I by pi b square minus a square pi into c square. This I value substituted in ampere circuit law. Integral dl gives this total circumference, c area circumference. See, this is 2 pi c. So b 2 pi c is equal to mu naught I pi c square by pi b square minus a square. Cancel pi and c, we got this answer. Clear?